This is a lecture on information system security. Today we are going to discuss unit 3, which is public key crypto system. In this unit we will discuss the requirements and the crypto analysis of the public key crypto system, the RSA crypto system, the Rabin crypto system, the Elgamal crypto system and the elliptic curve crypto system. So let's start with what is the public key crypto system and what are its characteristics and the requirement. So asymmetric algorithm rely on one key for encryption and a different but related key for decryption. These algorithms have the following characteristics. So first one, it is computationally infeasible to determine the decryption key given only knowledge of the cryptographic algorithm and the encryption key. In addition, some algorithms such as RSA also exhibit the following characteristics, which are either of the two related keys can be used for encryption with the other used for decryption. So in public crypto system, out of the two key, any one of the key can be used for the encryption and the other can be used for the decryption. So either we can use the private for the encryption or either we can use the public for the encryption, depending on the conditions what are our requirement for the crypto system. So a public key crypto system has six components. The first one is the plain text, which is the readable message from the sender, and the second is the encryption algorithm. So this is the algorithm which perform the various transformation on the plain text. The third component is public and private key. So this is a pair of keys that have been selected so that if one is used for encryption, the other is used for decryption. So the exact transformation performed by the algorithm depend on the public or the private key that it provided as input. So the fourth component is the ciphertext. So this is the scrambled message produced as output. It depends on the plain text and the key. For a given message, two different keys will produce two different ciphertext. So this output means the ciphertext depends upon the plain text and the encryption key. Now decryption algorithm. So this algorithm accepts the ciphertext and the matching key and produces the plain text. Requirements for public key cryptography. So the first requirement, it is computationally easy for a party B to generate a pair which is the public key and the private key. The second, it is computationally easy for a sender A knowing the public key and the message to be encrypted M to generate the corresponding ciphertext. So ciphertext is equal to encryption of the message using the public key of the receiver B. Now third requirement, it is computationally easy for the receiver B to decrypt the resulting ciphertext using the private key to recover the original message. So the original message is recovered by decrypting the ciphertext using the encryption algorithm in the reverse manner and by applying the private key. So it is computationally infeasible for an adversary knowing the public key to determine the private key. So the fourth requirement say that if any attacker has the public key of the receiver, then he is not able to generate his private key using the public key. So fifth requirement say it is computationally infeasible for an adversary knowing the public key P and a cipher text C to recover the original message M. So the fifth requirement is saying that if an attacker has the public key of the sender denoted by public key of P and a cipher text C, so knowing this information, the attacker cannot compute the original message M. The two key can be applied in either order. So the sixth requirement say that out of the two key pairs, that is the public key and private key, any one of the key is used for encryption and the corresponding for the decryption. So suppose if the public key is used for the encryption, then the private key is used for the decryption. And suppose if the private key is used for the encryption, then the public key will be used for the encryption. Now the RSA crypto system. So this crypto system is the initial system. It remains most employed crypto system even today. The system was invented by three scholars, that is Ron Rivest, Adi Shamir and Len Edelman. So generation of the RSA key pair. So each person or a party who desire to participate in communication using encryption need to generate a pair of keys, namely the public and the private key. The process followed in the generation of key is described as follows. So first, the user have to select two large prime numbers P and Q. Now calculate N equal to P into Q. For strong unbreakable encryption, let N be a large number, typically a minimum of 512 bits. Now find the derived number E. So number E must be greater than 1 and less than P minus 1 into Q minus 1. There must be no common factor for E and P minus 1 and Q into Q minus 1 except for 1. In other words, two numbers E and P minus 1 into Q minus 1 are co-prime. Form the public key. The pair of numbers N, E form the RSA public key and is made public. Interestingly, though N is part of the public key, difficulty in factorizing a large prime number ensures that attacker cannot find infinite time the two primes P and Q used to obtain N. This is the strength of the RSA. So even if the number N is made public, so this number is very large and so it is not very easy to factorize N into P and Q. So this is the reason for the security or the strength of the RSA. Generate the private key. So private key D is calculated from P and Q and E for given N and E. There is a unique number D. So number D is the inverse of E modulo P minus 1 into Q minus 1. This means that D is the number less than P minus 1 into Q minus 1, such that when multiplied by E, it is equal to 1 modulo P minus 1 into Q minus 1. And this relationship is expressed mathematically as E into D is equal to 1 mod P minus 1 into Q minus 1. Encryption and decryption. Once the key pairs has been generated, the process of encryption and decryption are relatively straightforward and computationally easy. Interestingly, RSA does not directly operate on strings of the bits as in case of symmetric key encryption. It operates on numbers modulo n. Hence, it is necessary to represent the plain text as a series of numbers less than n. RSA encryption. Suppose the sender wishes to send some text message to someone whose public key is N, E. The sender then represents the plain text as a series of numbers less than N. To encrypt the first plain text P, which is a number modulo N, the encryption process is simply denoted as ciphertext equal to plain text key power encryption key E mod of N. RSA decryption. So the decryption process of RSA is also very straightforward. Suppose that the receiver of public key pair N, E has received a ciphertext C. The receiver has a C to the power of his private key D. This result in the plain text P. So plain text equal to ciphertext key power decryption key D mod of N. RSA analysis. So the security of RSA depends on the strength of the two separate functions. The RSA crypto system is most popular public key crypto system, strength of which is based on practical difficulty of factorizing the very large number. So encryption function. So it is considered as one way function of converting plain text into ciphertext and can be reversed only with the knowledge of the private key D. And the second is the key generation. So the difficulty of determining a private key from an RSA public key is equivalent to factoring the modulus N. An attacker thus cannot use knowledge of an RSA public key to determine the RSA private key unless he can factor N. So it is also a one-way function. Going from P and Q values to modulus N is easy, but reverse is not possible. So basically the number N is made public, but so it is very difficult to factorize N. So the calculation of the private key depends upon the P and Q, and so it is not feasible to determine P and Q out of the N. So it is very difficult to calculate the private key knowing the value N. Thank you.